What? Yo, raps, hip-hops, MTV,
we thugs. Shouldn't have given you a headset.
G-Dogs, we coming to you live and uncut from the floor of PAX West. And by that I mean we're at home. Sad.
You didn't, you're going on the scarf joke, I forgot tonight. I was wearing this.
Oh.
That was super easy to take care of. All right.
Got your back. That's the point of it. Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of... What's that name, Phil?
It's Attract Mode. It's Destructoid Attract Mode. Or Damn for short.
Damn! That's a good-ass name. My facial hair looks terrible.
That, so does mine. So we're both in the same facial hair boat.
Jesus
But that's
Christ.
Okay.
Because we're playing a game not about facial hair today.
It's true.
So you guys may have heard we were talking about this all week. We're gonna be playing High Blood Drifter today, guys. As you can probably see by Henry Hyperlight in the back.
The one and only.
They haven't given him a name. They call him the Drifter, I believe. But we're gonna call him Henry Hyperlight.
Okay.
So,
I'm down for that.
That's important. LC Flygon, you don't feel welcome. Well, come on in, buddy. Sit down. Have a drink. Take your shoes off. We're gonna have a good time today. We're gonna be playing. Playing Hyperlight, it's gonna be a hell of a time we've got.
So we'll be playing for about an hour, and then we're going to be having guests on to talk about the game.
We
from
will.
PAX.
The game is developed by three dudes right now, so I'm still allowed to like it, you know, cause jokes. And we'll be having at the very least one dude on, maybe all three.
So we'll see how it goes, but we will have guests on, and they will be talking about the game.
At the very least, we will have studio head Alex Preston. Who, if you guys remember, the Hyperlight Drifter was actually kickstarted. They asked for 26,000. They ended up with like 65,000. It was a great success, and everybody was like, "Oh wow, you know, unique and creative, beautiful games get to work." But it was predominantly his project. He had some help from Bo Blythe, the creator of Samurai Gun.
Samurai, which we love. Here at the channel, we played a bit.
Yeah, it's an absolutely fantastic game. And now they have actually a good friend of mine, Teddy, who's working on the game. So it's going to be quite a bit of fun. We're going to have some guests in. This is the build you guys can go see right now if you're at PAX East. You can go touch it. If you're at PAX East, why are you watching this? You should be on the floor.
And you should be playing it for yourself.
I think the floor is open for like another hour over there.
Oh yeah, that's right, I forgot, because time zones.
Time zones. So, if not, you know, over here. It was 600,000, Saint? See, I thought it was 600,000, but then, okay, and Widefire is correcting me, but then I was talking to Alex last night, and he said 65, but he might have misspoken, so.
That's
all right. There we go. I thought it was close to a million, and I was like, that seems awfully low. So, okay, then never mind. I've been re-correct. I was right the first time, and then I got confused, and now we're back together. This is a great way for all of our new fans to think that we are the right people to show off this game.
Right?
Stay some blatantly incorrect things.
Yeah, so the actual build that we have has a single player chunk that's a pretty good flavor testing offering. And then we also have the cooperative horde mode.
Yes. We're going to have it's a doozy. I was playing it
You keep throwing that doozy word around.
I get hype on that dooze.
Oh boy.
Oh,
yeah, boy. I'm sure you guys, you don't want to hear us talk is that much.
Well, we're going to do it anyway.
You want to see the game.
Welcome to America.
I mean, you're going to hear us talk the whole time, all 4 hours.
Mm-hmm.
But video games.
Oh my god, look at that.
Right?
You want to like roll around in there a bit, or you want me to jump right in and we can both do it, or... LC Flygon, the most qualified people I've ever seen.
Hold on. Make sure we got the music, the sound.
The music is done by Disasterpiece, who is a very, very popular indie composer. He did Fez. He's probably the biggest
thing out there. I need to turn this on. There we go. Okay. So do you want to do the single player part first, or do you want to do some horde mode first?
Let's do some horde mode while people file in, then we can do some single player, and then we can do horde mode. Zen Message, you did hear co-op horde mode, which, despite how closely I have been following this game, I did not know was a thing. So why have I not jumped in yet?
Just press start. Well, you're not good enough. You're not cool enough.
So, in my defense, this game is a build. It's a very rough build.
It's very early.
See, we should make very clear, this game is a pre-beta build. So... If things break, don't get too mad. They just announced a delay for the game, which everybody was pretty positive about. They're like, okay, cool, yeah, you make the game you need to make. Can I jump in on that?
You should be able to jump in any time.
It won't let me.
If I gotta restart the game, I'll do it.
You might have to restart the game.
I'll restart
the game. But yeah, this game is coming out of pretty much everything. Plutocorn, LC Flygon is doubling down on that. Whitefire, Xbox One, PS4, PC, and Vita. I believe that's all of them. I hope so. So, really great stuff. I'm looking forward to it. This is one of my most anticipated games, which is why I was so excited that we got to show this off. Did it break?
It didn't break. It's starting. Ah. And then it's going into windowed mode. And then we can stream it, because we need to have it in windowed mode. There we go, and you're in.
Sweet. Look at us. I'm the
you're the gray one.
It is coming to Wii U. Is it coming to Ouya? I'm not sure if that's true. We can ask Alex and whoever else shows up when they come in here.
So yeah, items. My favorites are the flipping
that stick.
The Jedi lightsaber thing, and you get like the sniper rifle that you can aim.
Yeah, so we got a couple of things in here we can pull off here. So I've got the stick thing, and then you can... Oh, I got the gun too. Well, I didn't have it. And then you've got a grenade kind of throw, and then you've got a mine, which is nice. And then you get... The other one is like a shotgun kind of thing, which is one of my favorites. So.
The shotgun's pretty nice.
Oh, wait, that was the wrong one. Oops.
Well, we've only got a chance to play this a little bit. We literally got sent, like... Like, we got sent one build, and then they're like, wait, we got some more new stuff. And then, like that's the... There's app packs still working on the game.
Yeah.
Like... That's the thing.
You can dash as long as you change directions, which is cool.
Oh, that was what it was. I thought it was a timing thing. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. So I thought it was, like, you had to time it as soon as it made the sound. So yeah, this is like the waiting lobby for the horde stuff. If we want to start it, we can go up.
Is this the new Starbound? Not quite, 1290-80. Alright, so we can jump in here. The game itself is really good. It's like a...
That music. You can hear the music this time! That's really weird! I'm not used to that!
Yeah, no, I can hear the music. So this is... I usually don't have headsets on, but... What's up, Music Monkey? Once you're good to see you. You were... Well, Music Monkey was in here yesterday. I don't know if you're... Okay. So we're still figuring stuff out about this game. I think you can dash into bullets to eat them.
Really?
That's the one I... Oh, crap.
There we go.
That boomerang tech.
I'm not moving here. Take your stuff.
I'm getting it for Vita. Yeah, no, LC Flygon. I'm... Oh, God. Oh, God.
Don't get got, because if you get got, I have to... Take the health hit.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Also, if I die, the game's
over.
Oh,
God.
I said if I die, the game's over. You let me die because you died twice.
Okay, that was an accident.
So, the way that health works in the game, if Spencer dies, it takes a chunk of health out of me to bring him back because I'm the main player.
Yeah.
And if I die, it's just over.
Has there been any mention of price in this game? No, but I believe they're shooting for like the standard kind of $15 model for it. You can buy it right now on HyperLightDrifter.com. I think it's HyperLightDrifter.com. I was prepared.
This game is super pretty.
Oh my god, I just want to like roll around in it forever. Music is good. God, the animation in this game, there's so many like little frames in there. Heartmachine.com, that's it, heart-machine.com. You can buy it, you can get a special like a special edition kind of thing. It's got a print. I think it's a print.
I can't know better than I do.
Yeah, and that's like 42. There's also the regular one for the 15. So you guys can go there, check it out.
So, fun fact, those of you who follow me on Twitter last night probably ran into my tweeting about how my computer was dying.
Yeah, you still haven't told me how you fixed that.
It's really involved and really intricate.
Was it something involving a
basically,
pack of
hold on. Oh. I'm not going to get to the end before I get to the beginning. You know, let me start to tell a story.
Satan shows up at the end.
So, I go and I'm like, you know, it's been telling me that there's a new update for my NVIDIA card for a while. Sure, I'll do it. Why not? And then I hit it, I leave the room and I let it install, and I come back and I find that my monitor resolution is set to 800 by 600.
And, the resolution of kings.
And there is no video drivers anymore. It basically uninstalled the video drivers and was like, hey, the installation failed, so you don't have a video card anymore. I'm like, okay, well, I'll just reinstall it, something like that. So I go into my device manager, I go and check on the actual video card. It's listed as an identified device. It doesn't know what it is, and it says that the access to it is denied. So I can't install anything or change anything, and I sat there for hours trying to figure out what to do. And I finally fixed it this morning.
What's up, Nightwolf? Good to see ya. Doc Burns, you can play Mercenary Kings last day or so, and yeah, no, I'm all about sprite-based games as well. I still want, I'd love an HD collection of some of the 2D Castlevanias. Like, give me, I don't know, like, Symphony of the Night, Circle of the Moon, and Aria of Sorrow. That's just like a three-bundle collection. All of them, like, next-gen, beautiful, beautiful stuff. Oh, man. What's up, Wildebeef?
I wish I could have just been like, yeah, it was because I watched a whole bunch of hentai or something. But
or you loaded up 40 pics of the French, or 40 gifs of the French pop singer Alizé.
Well, Alizé is great, though. That's a great way to ruin your power supply.
Damn it, Phil. If you guys didn't know, one time Phil thought it'd be a good idea to see how many windows of gifs of Alizé he could open up.
It's the one
computer.
Where she did that, like butt wave move?
It's the Night Elf dance from World of Warcraft?
Yes, it's the Night Elf dance from World of Warcraft. That's what she does. So I basically killed Spencer's computer by loading up dancing gifs of French pop stars.
How many weapons are there in this game? Hint, Hunter. Well, this is pre-beta, so
well,
right now
you can
what,
sit here and look at it.
Five
you've got
plus
this,
a sword,
and then there's also other pages. So there's, yeah, there's two pages of that many weapons. So there's probably a good amount. Is a good thing to guess, but
yeah. I really like his dashing.
Yeah, the dashing's super fun.
Reminds you of Fez, Philly Scorpio. I mean, I can see some of that in the really nice sprite work, and it does have the same, the soundtrack is done by the same guy, so. What's up, Pac Bruno?
Talk about Alizé back in 5 minutes, uh-oh.
We talk about porn an awful lot.
You're disgusting, Phil. I'm disgusted by you.
You're no better.
Zen message, I was saying I want a Castlevania HD version. I'd be all about that life.
Epidemic.
Ah, Fairy Stuff is back. Fake Karen Gillan.
Good times.
Man, I love that sword throw thing.
No, it's great.
Because it looks like your sword, but it's not your sword.
It lets me live out all of my Jedi fantasies.
You know about the heavy attack, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yo.
I know all about this. Also do a dash attack, too.
This game is very pretty and good.
can't wait to play more of it. Like, we'll try out the single player stuff here in a bit.
Nolan Elric, I don't know what that means. Long until this out, John Michael Howe. A while. It's they just announced a delay. The beta is coming out in June. So.
Can I set this to both buttons? No, I can't.
Where's the shotgun? The shotgun's looking on the guys.
Yeah, but sniper though. I assume it's a sniper. Yeah. I really like it.
This does kind of remind me of Smash TV. That's a good call, Mario.
Yeah.
So much feeling on what this game is. Will it be? If this is Hyper Light Drifter, it is a top-down exploration-y kind of game with a really cool combat. I think kind of like, I want to say like Legend of Zelda Fez.
Legend of Fez?
Legend of Fezda. And it's got this really cool combat system. So right now, we're playing the co-op horde mode, which I did not know was a thing until just recently. So
that's a big guy.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Look at one of the fruit punches.
Where are they? They're on Tiny.
Okay. There's one in the bottom right corner.
This is too late.
Oh boy. Relax, because I'm hardcore.
So I need to not die. Is the
problem. You gotta calm down, bro. P-Dog in this game is very pretty. So if nothing else, you have that.
I mean, right now, it's kind of a weird thing to just kind of drop in on because we're playing the Horde mode, where it's just you fighting a whole bunch of enemies. There's actually a story and other stuff to go through.
Yeah, so the reason I mentioned Fez is that the way the game works, you know when you first played Fallout 3 and, like, you walk out of the vault?
Yeah.
How it, like, you can go kind of in any direction you want and you have, like, a way different story than everybody else?
Yeah.
That's kind of what this is. So the story is, it's divided into four directions. There's north, south, east, and west. And so as you play it, the part we have is a chunk from the very beginning of the north story. And so the story is like moves along kind of these four different paths, and there are different parts, and you have like these four different regions. What's up, Rent Check? Glad that we're making your Friday night. St. Connor says the more you use an item, the more it levels up. So that's pretty cool. Here and just chuck these sticks until I level up.
Yeah. I don't know.
I don't think that's how it works.
I don't know if there is a leveling up in this.
Oh, if you hold it down longer, you shoot the thing farther.
You can also aim it.
Can?
Yeah. You hold it down and you can aim it.
Oh, yeah, no. I mean, you can make it go into directions, but.
So just join. Don't be sorry for just joining. That's fine. It's Hyper Light Drifter.
Over Omega, you're linking Spencel stuff. Uh-oh. The sniper's a Harlite rifle. Yeah, we're not up on all of the names of the things yet. I mean, they've been very secrety about this game, but we've only been playing this morning.
Oh, there's the juice. Okay, I see.
Game makes me think of Bastion. Yeah, it's really pretty, like Bastion. Not in like the same way. Cave like Story Man. Yeah, I like all these games. Get the juice, dog. I didn't get to show it to Phil yet over Omega, so you can check it out. We got fan arts.
We do.
Fan
arts. We'll try to look for another
juice.
Yeah.
And I got up like 70. So I don't know what's happening.
Oh. Nope.
Oh.
God, jeez.
Getting a little bit of that slow-mo.
Is that the slow-mo from flipping Bro Force's back? I got it.
So I like that if you're damaged and you're walking around, you start trailing blood.
Yeah. Oh god, that's not what I wanted.
What the hell is that thing? Oh boy. It's not.
That thing shoots. Oh. I got
it. Sorry, bro.
So beautiful. Oh, I'm really down with that.
And yeah, that's, I think that's pretty apt. Yeah, the weapon collection. Sorry, I gotta. Because I'm so hardcore. We're getting better.
Okay.
Apparently, if you're good, you can last about 20 minutes.
Really?
That's what else. Dovlito, does the frame rate drop more enemies on screen? I think that's what we're doing.
It's
here.
The thing is, we're streaming this, and it's a game that isn't even, like, released yet, or in any way. So it's not greatly optimized yet for streaming. So this is. Like, this hasn't been streamed before.
No one, you guys suck at this game? Have you played before? Yeah, no, we got it literally this morning.
I played for like 5 minutes before while I was trying to get everything set up for the show. But like I said earlier, I was trying to fix my computer before everything.
So we're learning with you guys. I mean, anybody could just walk in and be the best, right? But we wanna show you guys the struggle, the hustle, learning to get better.
Hundred hours in Fez, holy cow.
Doc Burns, we're playing it on controllers right now. This build, the only way you can play.
That's a way to fall off. Nope. Don't die. Oh, you took health away from
me. Take you
again.
Out with
me. No, stop. We're gonna die in the lobby. What is that gonna mean?
You can eat it because you were busted. I just wanna show that he coughs up blood. He's like, bleh.
Well, you don't need to show people dying. We're gonna die all the time anyway. See here, maybe in 7 minutes we'll switch over to the story mode.
Maybe.
Because we've been playing this for a half hour. We'll play that for as long as it takes to go through it. Hopefully it'll last long enough to take us into when we have our guests on Skype. And we can sit here and just kind of play horde mode while we talk to them or go through the story again. And you guys can ask questions.
Well, that's actually a really interesting question. So what's the first video game you played that you fell in love with?
Grim Fandango.
This was Donkey Kong Country on Super Nintendo. When did you play Grim Fandango? Like, you were still a wee lad.
I was younger. Like, I'd actually played games, but I'd just, like... Because my parents both had, an Atari and an Intellivision. And I was just like, oh yeah, video games, whatever, they're cool, I guess. And then it wasn't until I actually sat down and played the demo for it first, and I was like, okay, this is kind of interesting, there's a story and stuff. And then my dad actually picked it up, and I'm like, well, I might as well play it. And I love the characters and the story and the atmosphere and art, everything. It just made me love games. Like, I finished the game, like, probably when I was it was really early in the morning, because I got up super early, I knew I was close to the end. It was a school day. And I finished the game before like 7 o'clock in the morning. And I was sitting there crying because I was really sad that I won't get to see those characters again. Like, I was sitting there. Okay, Fandango. But the fact that a game made me feel a thing like that made me realize that games are a thing that I really love.
Huh.
And it's something like that that I like a lot.
Yeah, mine was Pokemon Blue.
Oh, you can deflect shots. Okay. Okay! We just got a real match!
This game is really good. They're kind of cool. Why didn't we move forward? Because we're hanging out, man. We do this. We want to show the game. We want to show friendship. We want everybody to have a good time.
Oh, God.
So So if you guys are liking what you're seeing, you guys should go and comment on the post over on destructoid.com. It is the way you can help support us not getting fired by our bosses, which is, you know, an ever-looming reality. Wi-Fi can't you play this at PAX? Yeah, if you're at PAX East, this is the build you can currently play at PAX. So you guys can go check out Hyperblade there on the Mega Booth. So
Mega Booth was actually pretty big.
I mean, actually, it's always huge.
Like, I mean, it's considerably large.
Yeah, go get the juice, though.
I'm trying.
So yeah, I'm kind of excited that oh god.
Super pretty.
Oh, look at God, son. Oh, I hate the birds. The birds are assholes. You can only have them on the ground.
Or just turn them into flipping.
Oh my god.
Burn to a crisp with my microwave sniper or whatever it is. Ah!
Ooh, I got God.
I got God. We both got God.
Hey, Luigi! Yeah, this game is pretty awesome. I got XXX. So extreme. We're getting better.
Yeah. Well, no, you see, I mean, you don't just get good at a game. You have to sit there and actually play it before.
Alamario, the friendly fire right now is off. We're not sure if that'll be a thing in the final release. This is just... It's early.
Let's do one more of these. You got 3 minutes until we're going to switch over to the single player.
And it's true. Go to that link that Whitefire765 just wanted to go ahead and put up in there. That is where you can get the game right now. That is the game's website, heartmachine.com. Or it's heart-machine.com. So, you guys pop for Transistor? Hell yeah. That game's coming out like next month. Slow-mo. Ooh, I drank the juice.